Has this ever happened to you? You've been having a seat, doing your business, and then you flush. And all your business goes down the drain. Wait for it. Here you can take a look at the shitfish. Anyway, very soon, something's gonna happen. I don't know how well that came out on camera, but if you didn't hear it, don't mind the little Pooh Bears and stuff, my wife. If you didn't hear that, it's known as water hammer. And we're going to deal with that, because, hey, what a pain in the arse. Makes it feel like your house is going to blow up any second. There's more than one reason for water hammer. There can be air in a line somewhere. Maybe you got a small leak in your system. But I'm pretty sure this one is due to the toilet, because it only happens when you flush. And that's usually a good sign. One of the things that can go wrong with it is this filler valve. The innards will fail, and however they fail, and then as the water's coming in, it vibrates and I guess goes through the whole system. I don't know. I'm not a plumber. I can fix these things, but I don't know why they happen. Another reason would be the shutoff valve. The gaskets or O-rings or whatever's in there will fray and then vibrate as the water comes through, and just makes for a real good party in the house. I'm not sure which one it is, and this shutoff valve is pretty crap, so I'm going to change them both. First things first, shut the water off downstairs, or wherever your cutoff is. If I was just changing this and wasn't worried about my shutoff, then you can just cut the water off there and you can do all this. But because I'm changing both, I need the main water shut off. I've flushed and gotten all the water out. No water. And there's a little bit of water trapped in there. But I'm not going to really worry about it too much. It's not going to be the end of the world. Can't find a sponge. Normally you take a sponge and just sponge up all the water and get it all out of there, but a little bit of water on the floor is not going to kill me. First, I'm going to change the shutoff. Your stop might be different than mine. I'm using a straight stop that'll line up with my braided there. And it's threaded on the inside because my copper piping has a soldered male thread on it. I'm just hoping that this is the right size. If not, I'll be taking a quick trip to the hardware store. Anyway, check yours. If you're not into soldering and you have a soldered one, you can cut that off and get a compression fit that goes right onto the straight pipe. So you tighten it up. Boom, compression fit with a thread on the other end so this can thread in. I'll be showing you this one, which is pretty basic. You take the old one off, put the old one on with some thread, thread seal, plumber's tape, I guess they call it. Got an old t-shirt. that I'll just put down here just to soak up any water that is going to be coming out of there. And my cigarette hanging out of my mouth there, making me hack. Now, because I have a solder job that I have to worry about here, it's very important that you only turn the top and not the bottom, because you could twist that solder off and then boom, I'm off to the hardware store to get a compression fitting because I don't have any propane. First, I'm going to remove this. That is, it'll make it easier to work on. Ah, darn. There we go. Oh, there goes the water. Oh my God. I'm drowning. There. Now I'll be able to twist that without getting obstructions. Well, that kind of sucked. I thought I'd turn the camera on, but I didn't. Anyways, basically all I did, supported the bottom nut, turned this only. Put some Teflon tape on here. It screws in this away, so wrap your tape this away. Don't wrap the tape the other way, because when you try to turn it on, it'll back the tape off. Keep the tape in the direction that you're going to be putting whatever's on there. It's Teflon tape, known as plumber's tape. It's real thin and stuff like that. Goes around with threads. So, if you're screwing in this away, then wrap the tape this away. That way, as you're screwing in, this end trail here will keep going around with the thread. If you put it in backwards, then you know it starts to back out and it's not a very good seal. So I apologize for not showing you what I did to change that valve, but it was pretty basic. None of this needs to be tightened more than it has to be. If you get a leak and tighten it a little bit till your leak stops, that's it. You don't want to over tighten this stuff. So many people think that they gotta hold the house up with it and tighten it, and then they break it, and then they go, "Wah!"
Well, when I was going through editing the video for this, I realized that I was saying things like bottom, top, this, thinking that you could see it from the angle I had the camera, and you could see what I was pointing to, but it didn't look identifiable through there, so I'm doing this little one just to show you what I did there that you couldn't really see. So when I was referring to bottom, I was referring to your copper pipe. Right here is a nut with a thread, a male thread, that goes up into the shutout. It's soldered to the copper pipe. First thing I did, got my pliers and I removed this nut for the braided hose, got it out of the way so that now you're only seeing this, and now when I loosen this I can spin it off without this being in the way. What I was talking about here, I put one set of pliers on the bottom nut and I braced it against the wall and held it so that this didn't move or twist with this. Put the other set of pliers on here, because it's shaped like a nut as well. Twist this only. Off it goes. Then I threaded the shutoff valve on. Tighten it up. That's good to go. Next, if I can get my yoga positions here, I removed this plastic nut, which holds the braided hose to the bottom of the tank. This plastic nut holds the filler valve. Remove that. Take it off. Now your filler valve is ready to be removed from the tank.